an ambassador in Ghana. I'm telling you, they have, and they have their embassy here. They have businesses. They are running businesses. People from Europe, the whites, they are running businesses here. Some of them have lived here for so many years, and they are making so much money. And you are there as a black person. They've been told, like they've told you that Africa is this, Africa is that. So you are scared to come to Africa.
Yes, so hello, hello, hello. Welcome to my channel once again, once again. Today too, I am in the house, and I just want to talk about something. I don't know what I should call it, mistakes, or should I say I am advising African Americans and the blacks in the diaspora, basically, who come to Africa. Sometimes it's sad when you hear, you know, my first point that I want to give is some of the African Americans or the blacks in the diaspora, when they come to Africa, or when they are even coming to Africa, or when they even hear the name Africa, it scares them. Let me tell you, you have been brainwashed for a very, very long time, and sometimes it's even sad when you hear some blacks in the diaspora talk about Africa. It's sad. But what I always say is, if you haven't been to a place and someone is telling you about that place, please be careful. Or what I will say is, try and visit that place. Try and visit the place for yourself to at least know what exactly that place, or how the place is, or what that place can offer you. It's sad when you hear some black people, you know, I watch videos on YouTube, and sometimes some people do some YouTubers do some street vlogs, and when they are doing these vlogs, they ask black kids to even mention just 5 African countries. And it's very, very, very sad. It's very, very, very sad. It, like, just 5 African countries, and they can't even mention. We have 55 African countries in this African continent, and just 5, they can't even mention 5. It's sad. They have been brainwashed. They have been brainwashed to the extent that they don't even want to hear the name Africa. They don't, like, when they hear even their friends, I've actually spoken with some African Americans, and trust me, what they say is, when they tell their friends in the diaspora that they are coming to Africa, it scares them, because all they've heard about Africa is full of disease, Africans live in a bush, and all sorts of things. That perception, I will tell you, if you are an African American or a black in the diaspora who wants to visit Africa, or who has never made his or her mind to visit Africa, I'm telling you, just make that trip. People who tell you that Africa is this, Africa is that, I'm telling you, they are here. The whites, they are here. The Chinese, they are here. Everybody is here. Let me use Ghana for example. Have you ever asked yourself that the US, does the US has a representative, does an ambassador in Ghana? I'm telling you, they have, and they have their embassy here. They have businesses. They are running businesses. People from Europe, the whites, they are running businesses here. Some of them have lived here for so many years, and they are making so much money. And you are there as a black person. They've been told, like they've told you that Africa is this, Africa is that. So you are scared to come to Africa. Let me tell you, these people, they know what they get from Africa, and they know the amount of money they are making from Africa. So if you are there and you think the continent is what they tell you, I am telling you, people are doing what? Cashing out on Africa. especially the whites, they are crashing out on Africa. If you don't know, I am telling you today. It's funny, eh? You have your own continent. Any black person in the diaspora, this is your continent. Ghana is your country. Nigeria is your country. Kenya is your country. You can come everywhere, anywhere that you choose. We have 55 African countries. You can choose wherever that you want to come. So what is stopping you? Just what you've heard? That is what is stopping you? Give me a break, please. Rethink again. That's what I will tell you. Rethink again. Because I'm telling you, these same white people, these Chinese, these same people are cashing in, and they are making a lot of money from Africa. Some of them are mining gold, bauxite. They are into quarry. They've opened businesses. Come and look at the Chinese, the China malls that we have in Ghana, especially Accra, the capital. Now, these people have businesses here. So what is scaring you? They are living in good, like, when you come, just visit. The only thing I will tell you is just visit. I don't want to talk much on this topic. Just visit, and you will see what I'm talking about. Let me move to my next point. Blacks who come to Africa, who have seen the light and also come to Africa. One thing that I don't like, listen, it is your money. It is your money. But if you come to Ghana and you want to, or you come to Africa and you want to live comfortably, listen, as black people, one advice that I would give is that we should try and learn to do what? To invest our monies. We should try and learn to invest our monies. A black person will come from UK or US or Europe and come and stay in a hotel or an Airbnb that costs about $1,000 a night, $1,005 a night. I'm telling you, we have that in Africa. And these are the places that these diasporans, some of them, when they come, they sleep in. Listen, why you are coming to a place to visit? I know it is your money, but sleeping in $1,000 or $1,005 Airbnb a night? And listen, some of them, they sleep in these Airbnbs about a week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, and they are there. Man, that money, I know it is your money, but let me tell you, $1,000 in Ghana, for instance, is 6,000 Ghana cedis. That is a whole capital for about two or three or four people, depending on the type of business that you want to do. And you just come to Africa and spend it one night. Why are black people like that? Like, I just don't understand. Why can't you invest that money and also gradually build that particular type of Airbnb that you slept in or you want to sleep in? Why? We spend money anyhow. Like, we spend money anyhow. We travel even more than the whites. Vacations here and there, and we spend huge sums of monies. We should put a stop to this thing, Charlie. Black people should, like, I want to see black people coming together. I want to see black people coming together, like three, especially these black celebrities, the footballers, the musicians, the movie actors. Like, I want to see them come together. You have the money. Come together and build Africa. I'm telling you, the taxes that you are paying in America, like down here, you will not even pay such taxes that you pay over there. And you will make your money. Like, the money that you make here, you don't know. I'm telling you, these whites are here. They are making money. They are making money. If you see the businesses that they have here, I'm telling you, they are making millions of dollars. And you are there as a black person and you are afraid to come to Africa. You are afraid to come to Africa. You don't know what you are missing. You don't know what you are missing. Let me move to the next topic. I mostly hear black people come to Africa and they say whenever they go to town to buy something, they get cheated. They say they go to town to buy stuffs and they get cheated. Let me tell you, this is an advice to you. This is an advice to you. You go to town to buy stuffs and you get cheated. This is a general thing. I have actually spoken with some people from, like, not even people who have actually traveled, not just in Ghana, but other parts of the world. They will tell you, if you are a visitor in any part of this world, or a visitor or a tourist in any part of this world, when you are going to buy something in town, you will be cheated in one way or the other. It is not just Ghana, or it is not just Africa. It is not just Ghana, or it is not just Africa. The advice that I will give you is that, please, whenever you go to town, let me use Ghana for instance. Whenever you go to town and you want to buy something from any Ghanaian, and they mention the price to you, let them know that it's too expensive and you are going to pay this for that particular product that you're buying, or that particular thing that you're buying, or food that you are buying. If I were you, I will even divide the price that they gave me into two. For instance, if they tell me what I'm buying is $1,000, I'll tell them I'm paying $500. And it is there that you will see whether the person has given the thing to you at the right price or not. You can even see from their facial expression. You can even see from their facial expression that they are giving the product to you at a good price or not. They are giving it to you at a good price or not. Bargain. In Africa, we bargain a lot. So bargain. Even some of us that have lived here for so many years, they do it to us. Even some of us that have lived here for so many years, they do it to us. So you being a foreigner, or you being a visitor or a guest or a tourist or something, let me tell you, they will do it to you. So what you have to do is to stand on your feet and do what? Bargain. Bargain down, like bargain. That's what you have to do. You need to bargain. Yes. And this is my last point. I don't understand why some African Americans or blacks in the diaspora decide that when they are 60 years, 70 years, 50 years before they come to Africa, just to come and buy land, build, and retire here. Why don't we change? Why won't we change? Or why don't we change that thing by coming here at a younger age? Come and invest and employ. Listen, there are lots of graduates who don't have jobs. So sometimes you see people, they travel, like Africans, they travel to Europe, to America, to the UK and all these places. Let me tell you, it is because they don't have money. They are unemployed. That is the main reason why they go. Because these people, when they go to these places and they make their money, they even go as far as Qatar, Dubai, Abu Dhabi, all these places. Lebanon, or like people just want to travel because they just want to make it. You understand? But if they have the money here, let me tell you, if you are in Ghana or you are in Africa and you have money, let me tell you, it is the best place that you can ever be. Africa is the best place that you can ever be. Let me use Ghana because I'm from Ghana. I'm telling you, it is the best place that you can ever, ever be. Even the freedom, the peace that you have. So why are we like, I just don't understand. Why are we allowing ourselves to be, why? When you want to come to Africa, come at a younger age. a time that you know that you have money, you can invest, open businesses and employ Africans. But some of you wait till like you are 60, 70 before you come here to build your house, to buy land, build house and just retire. Then my question is, what are you actually adding to the economy to help Africa grow? To help Africa grow, what are you adding? What are you adding? We should change all these things that we do. We should try and come to Africa and invest properly. If you know any black celebrity out there, listen, in Ghana, there is one thing that really, really disturbs us a lot, especially in Accra and Kumasi, that is traffic. Anyone who has visited Ghana will tell you that is traffic. And my question is, in Ghana, we don't have a rail line that runs, let's say, from Accra to Kumasi, Accra to Takoradi. So my question is, can't these black celebrities come together and say, okay, we are coming to Africa to invest. So we've come to Ghana. We've seen that there is traffic. It is a problem for lots of people and even tourists. So why don't we construct a rail line from, let's say, Accra to Kumasi and from Accra to, let's say, Takoradi or Tamale? And I'm telling you, when you come together and you talk to the government and you have the money, you can go into agreement with the government and definitely, I know for sure, so far as you want to do something like that, the government will allow, so that you can build this and perhaps, depending on your agreement, operate it for some number of years, or even build and operate it like for yourself and perhaps give some 10% or 15% to the government as your tax or something. And I'm telling you, the money that you are going to make, because let me tell you, people travel from Kumasi to work in Accra, and one, the distance. So if I know that there is a train that is going to move around, let's say, 6 a.m. to Accra, and by 8:30 or 9 I'm in Accra, let's say about 2 hours, I'll be in Accra, then why will I even drive my car? So that is a point for me. Why will I even drive my car? So definitely the cars, or people who have cars, who want to drive to wherever they want to go to, it will automatically reduce, and the traffic will automatically do what? Come down. And these trolls that we have, these small buses that we have around, many of them are not going to come. People will be taking the train. So there wouldn't be much traffic in Accra and Kumasi. This is a business opportunity for the diasporans to even cash in and do something like that. And there are so many other things that I see as opportunity. People see them as problems, but I see them as opportunity. We cannot always depend on the government. We cannot always depend on the government. So we should try and do something. If we come here and we see a problem, I, for instance, see these problems as opportunities for you to invest your money and make huge sums of money out of it. But it's very hard for black people to come together and collaborate and do something like this. That is the problem. But we should try and do something like that. It will help us a lot. It will help us a lot. I just wanted to clear the air, just talk about these things. I just wanted to talk about these things because it bothers me a lot. And I think anyone who hear this and you know any black celebrity, we should, black people should just come together and build. It is very difficult for you to see black people coming together to build a company together or something together. It's very difficult, but we should try and do something like this. It will help us a lot. All these Chinese and the Europeans that you see in Africa, It is because they have the money. And they, and sometimes, like, someone might not even have the money, but they come together to do things together. We call it partnership. That's what they do. So we should try as much as possible and do something like that. Thank you so much for watching. Please, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, subscribe to my channel, and make sure you like the video, and comment whatever you feel like you want to comment. I will read the comments. I will actually read the comments. So thank you so much. Bye-bye.